Look, it's Mother's. She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us. Watching over us. Leading us home. Let's finish it.
There's nothing for us here.
Come.
So, I get that Mother was a giant. Which makes me part giant and part god.
And part mortal.
Right. I guess there's just one thing I don't understand. My name on the wall. Giants called me Loki?
Loki? That is the name your mother wanted for you when you were born. She must have called you that to her people.
But why?
A question for another day. Let us go home.
Did she know it was gonna be like this here? Is this what she wanted us to see? Did she want us to tell the people, or keep it a secret?
I do not know.
So what should we do?
I trust you to decide that.
Oh. So, why'd you want to name me Atreus? I know it can't be for a god.
No. He was a soldier. A Spartan.
The great warrior?
All Spartans are great warriors. We trained from birth. Our lives were discipline, duty, battle, and death. Life was grim, and we greeted it grimly. But Atreus of Sparta was unlike the rest of us. He wore a smile even in the worst of times. He was happy. He inspired us to hope that though we were machines of war, yet there was humanity in us. Goodness. When the day came for him to lay down his life in battle, His sacrifice saved countless others and turned the tide in our favor. I carried him home on his shield and buried him with all the honors of Spartan custom. His memory was a comfort in dark times.
Wow, you actually told a good story. Amir missed it. If you want to go home, but maybe helping people is part of why Mom sent us out here too. I mean, what would Atreus of Sparta do?
And what would Loki do?
Huh, that's a weird name. I'm glad we went with yours.
Am I glad to see you? I believe I've reached my limit for dwarven charm.
What happened, Mimir?
They took an uncomfortable number of measurements and then proceeded to bicker about the weather.
Where do you want us to take you?
How about the warm confines of anywhere bloody else?